6 is bad. A 7 is worse. Higher or lower, it's your choice. On Cut Sharks. And here's the host of Cut Sharks, Jim Perry.
Hello there. Welcome. Hi, thank you. 6 is bad, a 7 is worse, higher or lower, it's your church. That sounds more like Brooklyn than Phoenix, Arizona, Fred Flickstein, but thank you for that opening poem. I've got another poem for you. That's for Fred and his poem, but I have another one. This poem was sent in by Ann Warren, who's 14 years old, from Cascade, Maryland. And she sent in, listen to this, Gene. I like poems just like Gene Wood, only his are bad and mine are good. Let's bring out our champion who's going to play the money card, Jeff Wine. Hello, Jeff. Good to see you.
Thanks.
Good to see you again.
Thank you. Good to see you too, Jim.
You are doing very well, our theater manager, who has won $8,400 for the money card.
All right. Thanks. Thank you.
Are you feeling lucky now?
Yes, very lucky, Jim.
Let's get to it. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Hop up there, Jeff. Let's do as well this time, maybe better. You won $200 in the last game, which, of course, is yours to keep with a brand new deck of cards all shuffled and cut. We are going to give you new money, new deck of cards, and there's $200 on the bottom level in these three cards. See how we light everything up for you, Jeff, and we give you $200 on the next level and three more cards. Minimum bets are $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half your money. Jeff, you did well the first time. Let's do it again. Here's $200. As in the game, you have a choice of two base cards on the bottom level. Remember, when you change up to the second level, you can change your base card, and you can change your base card again before you make that big bet. Right now, you've got $200 and this base card. It is a jack. You want to play it?
I like that, hooker. I'll bet $100 it's lower.
$100 lower than a jack? It is a 4. Very much lower.
Good card. 300, and it's higher.
The whole thing, $300 higher than a 4. Yes,
right,
with a 6.
Right.
Doubling it to 600.
So now. I'll bet 100 that it's higher. No high, one high card so far. Higher.
Let's see a big one. $100 higher than a 6. Yes,
all
a 9.
All right.
Up to 700. Up goes the 9. We'll give you the other 200. You've got 900. Do you want to play that 9?
No, let's toss it out, Jim.
You can change the 9.
Ace.
Next card off the top of the deck is a 6. Little better card. You've got $900 and a 6, Jeff.
I haven't seen that many low cards out. I'm going to go $100 and go against the odds and say lower. Feeling lucky.
Lower.
Feeling lucky.
Very much against the odds. About 7 cards worth. $100 lower than a 6. Oh, no, it's an ace. But it only cost you $100, and you've got an ace now with $800, Jeff.
The whole thing lower. $800 lower.
$800 lower than an ace.
Yes,
with
right,
a 5.
All right. Decent card.
$1,600 and a 5.
$600 that it's higher, Jim. Let's get a good big card.
$600 higher than a 5. It
all
is a
right,
queen.
All right, good card.
$200 and up goes the queen. Do you want to play it on the big bet or change it?
I'll play it, Jim. Nice.
And you must bet
lady.
At least $1,100, Jeff. You've got $2,200 and a queen. What's your big bet?
Oh. I'll bet $1,200 on that lady that it's going to be lower. Be good to me, Jim.
$1,200 lower than a queen.
Hit it!
We're $3,400 in cash, Jeff. Way to go. Just had one bad card again, but you came back great.
Super card, Jim.
Come on down, Jeff. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And in two matches in cash, Jeff, you are up to $11,800.
This year.
We'll meet a new challenger right after this, so don't go away. Back with our champion, Jeff Wine, with $11,800. You're doing very well. You're a good
player. Thank you, Jim. Thank you. This is a super, super group here.
Good.
Super.
I didn't do it. Let's open the board and get to the cards. Janice and Bettina, if you will, load in the cards, and we'll meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Marla Schramm. Hi, Marla. Nice to meet you.
How are you doing, Jim?
Good to have you here.
Thank you.
Say hello to Jeff.
Oh, he's a real winner.
He's a good player. Tell us about yourself.
Well, my name is Marla Schramm. I'm currently living in Santa Monica. I'm a court reporter. I love water skiing, snow skiing, all house plants, and I have an identical twin sister.
Good. How is it growing up as a twin?
Very interesting.
Yeah. I've got to ask you one thing as a court reporter. Okay. Are you really writing anything when you're sitting there typing on that little box?
Oh, you better believe it. Every word.
Really?
Every cough, everything.
Good to have you here, Marla. Good
Thank
luck to
you,
both
Jim.
Of you.
Thank
Each
you.
Player has a deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled. The players cut them before we go on the air. Jeff, the champion, will play the upper cards, the red cards. Marla, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. And we start the best two out of three match with a question to you, Jeff. We asked 13-year-old boys, if a talent scout offered you a contract to star in a television series, but you had to dress as a fairy princess, would you do it? How many 13-year-old boys said they would dress as a fairy princess?
Oh, that takes a lot of razzing to do that. And I don't know if they realize about the money. I think it's kind of low. I'd say about 38.
38? 13-year-olds would take the part as the fairy princess, Marlo.
Well, I'm sure they'd have a lot of prompting from their parents about that, being 13 years old. I'm going to say it's going to be a touch higher.
Higher?
Higher.
If it is higher, Marla, you'll go to the board first. If not, it'll be Jeff. And the actual number of 13-year-old boys who would dress as a fairy princess to star in a television series is 32, not higher, Jeff. Yeah.
Good
Jeff,
cards now.
Your base card is a 10. Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it.
I'll change it this time, Jim.
Next card off the top of the deck is a 5. Good
change. That's better. Let's go high, Jim. High.
Higher than a 5? Yes, with another 10.
Got 10 back. Let's go low.
You're going to risk it. Lower than a 10. It is
all
a 2.
Right.
Very much lower.
Gotta go high, Jim. Gotta go
higher
high.
Higher than a 2. A 3.
All the way, Jim. All the way.
For the first
all
game
the
of the match, if this is higher, yes, with a 5. He's did it. Wow. We're set up for game 2, Dennis. Jeff, when you get going on those hot streaks, you just knock them off.
Oh, incredible.
And we'll set up with the same 2 decks of cards. Marley, you didn't get a chance.
I didn't get a chance to do anything. He is on a hot streak. No
Maybe
doubt
you'll
about
get
it.
On a streak this time. You need this game, and the question's going to you, Marla. We asked 100 single women between the ages of 21 and 40. Have you ever made a fool of yourself over a man?
Oh,
how many women said they had made a fool of themselves over a man?
They would be lying if they didn't admit it. Once in their life, I would have to say, I'd say 78.
78 women have made a fool of themselves over a man, Jeff.
Oh, I don't know if it's really that high. I think by the time they get to that age, they know what they're doing. I think it's lower.
What do you mean when they get to that age, 21 to 40?
Well, you know, 16, it would be higher. But
how old are you, Jeff?
23.
Well, I guess 21 to 40 would be that age to Jeff. Yeah, you say lower. The actual number of single women who have made fools of themselves over a man is 67. It's lower, Jeff.
Good card.
Yeah, good card. You've been getting them. An ace.
Oh, yeah. Lower, Jim. Lower
than an ace. It is a 7.
I'll freeze.
We'll freeze. Move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. Jeff, the question to you. We asked 100 marriage counselors across the country. Who are more sexually promiscuous, men or women? How many professional marriage counselors said men are more sexually promiscuous?
100. Whoa.
I don't know if you heard that lady's voice out of the audience there say 100, friends.
Well, being of the same sex and knowing the friends I know, I think it's pretty high. I say 80.
80?
80.
If professional marriage counselors, men are more sexually promiscuous, he says 80, Marla.
I agree with him, but I think it's going to have to be a touch lower.
You say lower than that.
Lower.
The actual number of marriage counselors who said men are more sexually promiscuous is 89, not lower, Jeff. Well, somehow I'm not sure if that's a compliment, Jeff. You've got
a
7. You want to change it?
Let's get rid of it, Jim.
Changing the 7 to a 3.
All right, great card. Higher.
Higher than
Jim.
A 3. Yes,
all
a 6.
Right. Let's go higher again. Let's go higher,
higher
again.
Higher than a 6. Oh, no! A 5 is lower. That is one of the few mistakes that Jeff has made. And Marla, you get a free chance to play a 9. You didn't win the question, you cannot change it.
Okay, it's going to be lower.
Lower than a 9. Yes,
yes.
A 6.
Yes. Okay, come on. It's going to be higher.
Air 86.
84.
Okay, I'm definitely going to freeze. Have to freeze
Marla
on 8.
Marla freezes with a one-card advantage as we fill in the spaces. Question to you, Marla. We asked 100 women. The last time you cried, was it because you were sad or because you were happy? How many women said the last time they cried, they were happy?
Oh, I'd like to think it would be a lot, but I'm going to have to say... I was going to say something close to that. 35.
35. Did you bring along a Greek chorus with you, Marla?
Yeah, I have some friends up there.
She says 35 women cried when they were happy rather than sad, Jeff?
Well, I agree with that. I think more women would cry when they're sad. I think lower.
Lower than that?
Yes. Yes.
The actual number of women who said the last time they cried they were happy is 25. It's lower, Jeff. Yes.
Be good.
You've got a 3, Jeff. Do you want
to play it? We'll play it and go higher. Higher.
You got a 3? Yes,
oh,
with a
good card. Good card. Lower, Jeff.
Lower than a king. A
all
4.
Right. All the way. Higher.
Higher for the championship. No. A 2. And you lose all 3 cards. A break from Marla. Play off the 8 and call this, Marla.
Oh, mercy. Okay. This is going to be... Higher.
Higher.
Higher
than an 8. No, a 5. Could not advance. Jeff needs 3 cards. Marla needs 2. Sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Jeff, we asked 100 men very simply, did you shave this morning? How many men said yes?
Oh, I shave every morning. I think almost all of them shave every morning. I'd say about 88.
88 shaved that morning, Marla.
I'm glad he said that. I'd have to say higher.
Higher.
I'd have to say higher because it's such a common practice. It's almost like brushing your teeth. Get up and shave.
Higher.
Higher.
The actual number of men who shaved that morning is 70. Not higher, Jeff. Now then, Jeff, you need 3 cards. Marla needs 2 cards. You've got the decision. Do you want to play it or pass it?
It's all yours, Marla.
Oh, all right, Marla, you cannot change the 8. You need both cards. If you can get them both, you've tied it up. One mistake, Jeff wins the championship.
It is definitely going to be higher this time.
Higher than 8? It wasn't
higher
the last time. Is it this
higher
time? Yes,
yes!
A 10.
Yes! This is really, really rough. The next card is going to be lower.
Lower than a 10.
Please.
Oh. No! It is not lower! And Jeff in sudden death wins the championship again! Oh, Marla, you came so close. Thank you.
Thank
you for joining us. Marla Schramm. Jeff, come on down here. Congratulations once again.
Thank you, Jim. Thank you.
We'll play the money card. Jeff's got $12,000 already. Money cards right after this.